الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. وبعد، brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters, here we are waiting for the beginning of another Ramadan. This Ramadan, let us try to make it a month of change, a month of returning to Allah, or what we call tawbah. Brothers and sisters, you know, when Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he would be expecting the month of Ramadan to be coming, he would be very excited, and he would begin preparation for the month long before the month of Ramadan. So tonight, brothers and sisters, before Ramadan begins, or tomorrow night, we don't know exactly, it depends on the sighting of the moon, but within the next day or so, the Ramadan will begin. So begin to make preparations and begin to make your schedules and so on. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, brothers and sisters, when Ramadan would come, he would make, and when, you know, when he would see the moon, the hilal, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would make a special dua. Again, appreciating what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had brought, and kind of hinting at what are some of the aims and the goals that he wanted to achieve in Ramadan. And of course, that has a bearing on all of us as well, brothers and sisters. So the dua that he would say when he would see the beginning of the month of Ramadan, when he would see the hilal, he would say, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Allahumma ahillahu alayna. Oh Allah, bring this hilal upon us, bil amni wal iman, with peace and with faith, with iman. Wa bis salamati wal islam, and bring it with a sense of security and Islam. Wa tawfiq, and oh Allah, get us to be successful. Lima tuhibbu rabbana wa tarda. Get us to be successful in what you would love for us, our Lord, to do, and what you would be pleased with, our Lord. Rabbuna wa rabbuka Allah, our Lord and your Lord. He would be talking about the hilal in the sky, that our Lord and your Lord is Allah. Brothers and sisters, such a powerful dua. In this dua, if we reflect upon it, there are like 10 different things that are mentioned in a very short way. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam starts out by saying Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, meaning that this is the priority in Ramadan for us. It's not a matter of just letting go of our food and not being intimate with our spouse and letting go of the worldly things, but the whole reason behind all of this is that to understand that we are nothing and Allah is the greatest, and we should be dedicating ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you know, sometimes people, they kind of face the moon as if they're like worshipping the moon. And the idea is to remind us that Allah is the creator of that moon. So it's not as if we're worshipping the moon or facing the moon. As a matter of fact, our pious predecessors, when the moon would come up, they would see it up in the sky, and then they would face down and they would make this dua. And even Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam himself would do the same thing to make sure that they're not worshipping the moon. They're worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of that moon. So he starts out the dua by saying, Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest. Allah is the highest priority in our lives. We should dedicate everything for Him. And that's where our sincerity comes in. That we clean out our hearts and make them totally pure and dedicate them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, and then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Allahumma ahillahu alayna, that bring this moon upon us in a state where we have total peace and iman. You see, iman means that we have to have this faith in Allah. We have to trust Allah. We have to be confident in Allah. We have to think good of Allah. We have to love Allah. And not to have any shirk, not to have any other priorities in our lives at all. And because we want to believe in not only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but what He's asked us to believe in, the Quran, the Islamic laws, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the angels, the Day of Judgment, his decrees and so on, and His books, all these things. And if we believe in them, then we will have this inner peace, we will have peace in our lives. And that's why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam is saying that bring this moon upon us, bring this hilal upon us in a state where there's peace, meaning in our hearts, through iman, through this faith. Because if we have that faith, then we're going to have that peace. وَبِالسَّلَامَةِ وَالْإِسْلَامِ, and that we have a sense of security, that we're secure from any catastrophes, any disasters, any problems, any trials, any troubles in our lives. How? If we practice our Islam, wal-Islam. If we do the things that Allah has asked us to do. Here, the word Islam implies the fact that we have totally submitted to Allah and we are going to obey Allah. And this is what Ramadan is supposed to be all about, to achieve that, to get away from all the problems of our lives and to be secure from these catastrophes and disasters by practicing our Islam. And then he said, "What tawfiq," and that Allah make us successful in to do what you love for us to do, that things that you love. And there's a lot of, subhanAllah, brothers and sisters, if those of us who know Arabic, you can feel that how the love is coming from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when he says that, you know, oh Allah, our Lord, that whatever you love for us, that's what we're going to do. And whatever you're pleased with, that's what we're going to do. Whatever you love, that's what we're going to aim to do. And that's what our intention is going to be. And we're definitely going to give it our best shot to do everything that you love, O Allah. And we pray to you, O Allah, that whatever we do, that you'll be pleased with it. رَبُّنَا وَرَبُّكَ اللَّهِ, our Lord and your Lord, talking to the moon, is Allah. Meaning, again, that the moon is just a creation of Allah. And we are a creation of Allah, and Allah is the one who provides for us, and Allah is the one who takes care of us, and so on. So brothers and sisters, this Ramadan, let's make it the best Ramadan possible. Let's make it the most beautiful Ramadan by returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as you know, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, in order to spot the moon, he said one time, صُومُوا لِرُؤْيَتِهِ وَأَفْطِرُوا لِرُؤْيَتِهِ. You know, fast when you see the moon. He didn't say anything about calculations now. He said, when you see the moon, and break your fast, meaning celebrate Eid, when you see the moon, for Shawwal that is. So, brothers and sisters, this evening, we, our community at Dar es Salaam, we will be waiting till the moon is sighted. In the Middle East, today the moon was not sighted. So, from what we understand, the moon is expected to be sighted in the Pacific Ocean, in the French Polynesian Islands, and so on. And once we know that the moon has been sighted, they're expecting it, but it hasn't been sighted yet. But once we know that it has been sighted, then inshallah we will announce that Ramadan will begin. They're hoping to see it tonight. The only challenge for us is, by the time they see it in the Polynesian Islands, here in Washington and Maryland, it's going to be about 11:30, 12 o'clock. So inshallah, as soon as we hear, we're going to post it on our website, and we'll get the message out. So keep in touch inshallah, and just watch out for the message on our website inshallah. And with that, inshallah, we hope and pray that you have a very beautiful Ramadan, a very happy Ramadan, a very successful Ramadan in coming back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that this time when you make the change, it's a change for the good. Brothers and sisters, inshallah, we hope to talk to you soon again. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.